Thank you. Y'all, thank you very much. I've learned to make a good speech. You got to stand up to be seen, speak out to be heard, and sit down to be appreciated. So I won't be long. There are some things I'd like to say. There one, I'd like to introduce my wife, Peggy. Peggy, stand up and take a bow, please. Mother of our two children, 39 years. Peggy Jean, Spartanburg, South Carolina. Y'all, we got work to do, as you know, watching the liberal press, the biased press. Academia is against us. Looks like the courts are turning against us, and when you lose those three, you got bad problems. But we have the strength and we have the power to change all of that. But it's going to take a whole lot of work. And when we talk about faith and freedom with this many people, with a great leader like Jeff Duncan, it does my heart good, because I know of that South Carolina motto. Our motto is Dumb Spyro Sparrow, which says, when I dream, I hope. As I breathe, I hope. So we're breathing and we're hoping. And we know it's going to get better. One quick story. As y'all might have noticed, I was one of the three that nominated Donald Trump for president. And on the way to Cleveland, thank you very much. On the way to Cleveland, I said, Peggy, did you ever in your wildest dream see your husband, Henry, nominating Donald Trump for president? She said, Henry, I hate to tell you, I never seen you in any of my wildest dreams. But y'all, I tell you, the Democrats' dreams were smashed on election night. Do you remember watching them? See, that's what we're up against. You could read it in their faces. All the news people from stem to stern, all of them, were so dramatically crushed that they could not help but show it. And you remember Ms. Hillary didn't even come out that night. She was sick or something. Well, I'll tell you, they are doing all they can do to ruin Donald Trump. It's hard to find someone telling the truth on the news anymore. And the truth is that the Democrats and these liberals and those on the left cannot stand the truth. And when Donald Trump tells it to them, they go wild. Well, I want to tell you this. I know Donald Trump. I campaigned for Donald Trump. I'm told I'm the first elected official in the country to endorse Donald Trump. I can guarantee Donald Trump is a friend of mine, and he's a friend of yours, and I can guarantee the liberal press that they cannot stop Donald Trump no matter what they do. They cannot stop Donald Trump. And speaking of not stopping, we can't stop South Carolina. This state is strong. I see these business people coming in from across the oceans, and they come in here. And often you learn the most about yourself by someone who's not right here with us. And they say this state is special. The people are different. It's a handshake state. They say this state is the only one that they've been to. When a man or woman tells you they go work, tells you they go keep the contract, tells you they are gonna be loyal, you can take it to the bank. They shake your hand, they depend on it. This is the only state like that that they've been to, and that's why they're coming here, and that's why they go keep on coming here. We're different, we're special. We can lead the way. Somebody is gonna have to lead the way, and it needs to be us. What is it that makes us so strong? I believe our 347 years in the crucible that existed all through those years in this country, battle after battle, challenge after challenge by man and nature, we have seen them all. We have people from Europe, we have people from Africa, we have people coming in now. We have the kind of people they don't have in some other states. We've been through everything, ups, downs, challenges, victory, defeat, everything. And right now we are on the way up. And that spirit and that strength is no more strongly demonstrated than by the men and women that we are here tonight to honor. And that is the men and women, the first responders, that is law enforcement, and the men and women of the United States military. There's not another group on earth like them. And that is what makes us so strong in this state. This is a military state. This is a law enforcement state. We believe in ourselves, and we are strong. Right quickly, how do you measure that? Where does it come from? Where does this desire, this commitment to protect, deserve, and defend, where does that come from? It's got to come from somewhere because it doesn't exist everywhere, although it exists here. One, I believe it starts with a belief in the Almighty. It starts with a belief in the Almighty. And ladies and gentlemen, I have to tell you, when Mother Emanuel, the tragedy there happened, and we had those South Carolinians go before the judge the next day to set bond for that young man, who the deranged, horrible man that killed those people, I had people calling me from all around the country, some from around the world, saying I never knew what it meant to be a Christian till I watched what happened in South Carolina with those people begging forgiveness for that criminal. That is strength. By the way, we had a case when I was in the Attorney General's office. We had a case where a Wiccan high priestess was challenging Great Falls because they had the temerity to start their city council meeting with a prayer to Jesus. And they got sued. And I told them, as Attorney General, speaking for you, I said, you go ahead and you pray to Jesus if that's what you want to do, and we'll defend you, because one day it's going to turn around. We have a strong belief in the value of life. The old, young, the unborn, we respect them all. And acting on your behalf, that's why I issued an executive order last week saying not a penny of South Carolina taxpayers' money would go to an abortion in the state of South Carolina as long as I could do anything about it. We got to stand up. Somebody's got to stand up. And there's more. It's those beliefs that make us strong. Also, the belief in law and order. That's why we honor our military, sir. That's why we honor the law enforcement. That's why we honor these men and women who run to danger to save us, despite their own safety, the threat to their own safety. What unusual people. We believe in law and order. We believe in protecting life, liberty, and property. And ladies and gentlemen, the Second Amendment is the core to that, and we'll stand tall for the Second Amendment as long as it takes to defeat those who would tear it down. And I'll just let you know, in case you missed it, the State Department, as you know, brings refugees into this country. The governors really have nothing much to say about it. They can't stop it. They bring them from different places, although we can voice our opinion on what we would like to do and not like to do. So acting on your behalf, the other day I filed the necessary papers to say, yes, of course, we will comply with the federal law, whereas where refugees are brought to our country, they are good. They are refugees that need help. We got nothing against refugees. They're facing all sorts of turmoil and problems. But I wrote then, and I say again to you, I say there are terrorists in the world, and we want no refugees from Iran, Libya, Somalia, Sudan, Syria, or Yemen, just like President Trump said, until those procedures can be made safe, sound, and secure. Finally, the Constitution. What a great document. The United States Constitution, the Declaration of Independence. That and the Bible, that's about all you need, is those three documents, and that'll get you wherever you need to go. We believe in that Constitution. And that's one reason, acting on your behalf, when President Obama got the Obamacare law through the Congress, I and 12 other attorneys general said we go file suit to stop it. He signed it. 6 minutes later, we filed our lawsuit, went to the U.S. Supreme Court. We lost there, but we won a lot of hearts. We won some minds. And ladies and gentlemen, it will be repealed. It will be repealed. And free enterprise and good health care will be ours. So I'm about through. There's so many things I'd like to tell you, but I got to say, we believe in each other in this state, and that's why we want to educate every child. The new ideas, without a good education, it's hard to get going, but we're going to educate them with new ideas, new approaches, and I believe South Carolina has stood tall on so many things. I believe this is another way, with good people, good spirit, good hearts, can see that we get this done here. So finally, I want to say to our veterans, to those serving in the armed forces today, to those in law enforcement, firefighters, all the first responders, your faith has given us our freedom. It has made us the greatest nation in the history of the world. And as just one man, I salute you. Thank you.